Hi, my name is Nick Stasoulis, and I'm a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this video, we will review the procedures for documenting an ADCP midsection measurement in SVMobile. This video will only cover the procedures for use of SVMobile specific to staging and importing a midsection ADCP measurement. Videos on the use of SVMobile for sensor and control inspections, high water marks, and other purposes can be found by visiting the USGS YouTube page at the address shown, selecting playlists, and selecting hydrotube training. Here we see the site visit tasks page in SVMobile, and we'll select discharge measurement to begin. On the page that follows, we will select new channel, enter the channel name, pick the midsection measurement method, and select your deployment method. For velocity method, you will select ADCP. A pop-up will ask if you'd like to stage the channel, and you will select yes. These steps should be done as you are setting up for your measurement before you've started collecting data. Staging will allow you to take notes on when the clock was synced, if the instrument or ADCP test was run, and if the compass was calibrated. You can ignore the GPS unit field and the moving bed present field. Some users chose to fill in the boat motor field with the trimaran information, or the manned boat they used, which might not be typical for this method. The temperature salinity readings page is where you need to document your ADCP temperature, reference temperature, and salinity, if needed. Be sure to select the units, add necessary comments, and select add. When collecting data, leave this page open so you can utilize the acoustic channel notes for comments related to data collection, site conditions, or other important observations. Once the measurement is complete, select Done and fill out the measurement location, flow condition, channel conditions, and velocity information. Here you will see the channel is listed as staged, as we have not yet brought in any discharge information. To do this, right-click on the channel and select Import. For TRDI Section by Section Pro, you will select the XML file, which is created by selecting File, XML Summary, Export. For Sontech River Surveyor Stationary Live, you'll use the Export Discharge Summary to ASCII icon, which will create a DIS file. After selecting the XML or DIS file, SVMobile will identify the file type, which you should confirm. Now scan through the channel information and fill out necessary fields, including a check next to Meter Inspected. Confirm your entries on the acoustic information page and confirm the imported midsection details. The channel summary should be complete, including the newly imported discharge. Back on the list of channels that make up your measurement, you could add another channel. But for this example, we'll enter a gauge height to check the measured flow against the reading and select Done. On the measurement summary, you need to identify the measurement number or have it auto-sequenced, rate the measurement, document the base flow condition, enter the measurement gauge height information, and populate the start and end times. Be sure to include comments in this dialog, but note that you do not need to duplicate any comments made in the acoustic information page. These will be pulled in automatically. Here you could note why a measurement was downrated, issues with measurement gauge height, or other measurement considerations. Once complete, select Done, which brings you to the Discharge Measurements page. It's important to note that the measurement file will need to be re-imported into SVMobile if changes are made after the original import. The series of YouTube videos mentioned previously covers the process of re-importing a measurement and is available through the HydroTube training playlist on the USGS YouTube channel. Hopefully, this brief demonstration was useful in outlining the basic process of staging and documenting a midsection ADCP measurement in SVMobile.